my channel. This is Mayuri and today I'm at a new location as usual, but today I'm gonna be doing something very different. I've not really tried staying in any of the hostels, which have been a long pending for me, and this time I decided to do so from one among these super famous hostels that everybody knows. As you can read in the title, it is the Zostel. So I am currently in Gokarna Zostel and I'm gonna be here for about a week with this wonderful view behind me, which you can see. So let's just talk about the staying arrangements. So there are dorms and there are also cottages that you can live. So these behind me are all the dorm rooms that you can see, and there are about 5 rooms, wherein one is about a mixed dorm room and 2 are for women and 2 are for men. So these dorm rooms are really pretty clean and neat, and there's a lot of space available, and there's also storage for your belongings that you can keep. So let's just start off with the most important part of Zostel, which I'm really excited and impressed, which is the dorm room. So we've just got one entire empty dorm room. Let's go check it out. So this is the dorm room, which has about 6 beds. So you see, this is a complete nice dorm room. You have storages below under your cot, and you also have a locker facility, and these beds are super comfortable. And I think for 6 people, if you're just traveling, I think this is pretty good enough room size, and you get to meet various different people here. So let's talk about the pricing of these dorms. So each bed would cost you about 650 rupees per night, and during the season it could go up to 850 to 1000 rupees. But this is really good, and you would need to do a deposit of 150 rupees for your locker, which is refundable. So let's just talk about how many people are allowed in these dorm rooms. So the whole concept of Zostel to actually create a dorm rooms here is for solo travelers, for backpackers, and somebody who's just traveling in group of 2 or 3. So the whole idea of this is that a person meets various different people who are traveling around, and not just stay in your own group and not mingle with others. So that's the whole motto, which is, I think, is a brilliant idea for sure. So if you're coming here, just make sure you're not in a group that is more than 4, because you will not be allowed. So the minimum is 1 and maximum is 4. So this is to the cottage room. So this is really nice if you're staying as a couple, but this would cost according to the season, which would range about 2.5 to 3. So you can even choose this if you're not okay with the dorm rooms. There's just so much area in front of the cottage that you can chill, and it's just really nice. Not necessary you will have to go till the cafeteria or the workspace to chill. You can even chill here at night times. Not just this, there's just ample amount of parking space available. So if you're coming by a 2-wheeler or a 4-wheeler, so it's just so much parking place that's available in this hostel. Now let's just talk about how to reach this place. So from wherever you are, catch a bus at night and you will arrive here approximately around 8 o'clock in the morning. So, and then you can just get down at the Gokarna bus stop, and then you can catch an auto from there. I definitely see a good auto services available here. The auto person will charge you around 100 to 150 bucks, and then you will be dropped just straight in front of the hostel. And if you're coming on your own, then you know it, just Google Maps does the magic. And if you're early, you can just sit here and wait till your room is ready. And you can see how well and neat this room is actually kept. There's just so many paintings which look so creative, and there's tables for you to actually work, and there's good internet as usual, there's good ventilation, and there are beds. If you really want to take a nap before your room is set, then there you are.